Hello and welcome to our first guidance video. We will go through an overview of the whole process of making 3D printable versions of the spare parts you need to repair your product. This is the 3D printing for repair process. You first have to start by finding out what stopped working in your product and identify the parts that need to be replaced. Once you have identified them, you will go through the following four phases. Analysis, where you study and identify the characteristics and needs of your parts. Redesign, where you can make your part fit for 3D printing. Manufacturing, where you produce your parts. And testing, where you verify the quality and fit of your parts, which you can then install in your product to finalize the repair.
In this overview, we will show you the process of repairing this kettle using FDM 3D printing. The problem with this kettle is quite straightforward. We can see here that the upper ring and switch are both broken. We will start by disassembling the product to get a better sense of what's going on. Before disassembling, always make sure to unplug your product. We have now extracted the broken components so we can start analyzing them. We first observe how the broken parts relate to the rest of the product. Here, we can see that the function of the broken part is to activate the internal switch. It is a moving part that has two pivoting points and is kept in place with two screws. We can see that the function of the top ring is to keep the cap of the kettle closed when the water is cooking. It does this through the hook on the front. We can also see that it is assembled to the kettle through a press fit. Let's now take a better look at each one of the parts. By checking the general dimensions, we can see that the top ring is actually not circular, but oval. We can also see its geometry consists of several bodies, making it quite complex. It also has very small sections, such as these snap fits at the bottom. We should also note down, this component won't be in the hot water, but will receive a good amount of steam. In the case of the switch, we see that we need to be careful and get the measurements right to have the pivoting points work correctly, as well as the front section, which will push the inside switch. An important characteristic of this part are these arms, which will have to withstand the force of the hand when pushing or pulling from it. We can observe the double curvatures, but they only seem to have an aesthetic purpose. From the analysis, we think there is a big chance a 3D printed top ring won't work, due to the complexity of its geometry and exposure to high temperatures. We do think the switch is very likely to work, considering its geometry and the forces it will have to withstand. So let's get to the redesign phase. We have a few ideas for the redesign of the top ring, and we simplified its geometry by reducing the amount of additional bodies. For the switch, we have decided to increase the thickness of the arms and simplify the double curvature. This will make the part easier to 3D model and faster to print. For both components, we have considered common design guidelines for FDM 3D printing. We will dive into those in the following videos. One of the most important guidelines to consider here is the printing direction of the parts to select a position that will make them stronger. We think these two materials are the best options for each one of the parts: high temperature PLA for the top ring and strong PLA for the switch. Now that we have a design, we can start digitizing the parts. We take as many measurements as possible using a caliper. The electronic caliper allows us to be as precise as possible. We also take a few pictures of orthogonal views in case we need them as a reference when 3D modeling. We then proceed to 3D model the parts. We will also provide further tips on how to do this in our following videos. Once the model is done, we export it into an STL file to be able to process it into the slicing software, which allows us to define all the printing settings and prepares a file that goes into the 3D printer. The software estimates 8 grams of material are needed for the switch and 14 grams for the top ring. The files go into the printer and we wait for the layers to shape our components. Once our parts are ready, it is time to work on them a little bit to get all that support material out. Before we install the parts, we weigh them and compare the result to the weight predicted by the slicing software. Since there is not a big difference between the two weights, we know the part was printed correctly and the machine is working properly. Through a visual inspection, we also verify the quality of the print. Since the quality is sufficient, we install the parts in the product and verify they fit properly. It's time for the big test. Let's see if the kettle is working with the new components. The top ring was not very successful. Even with the design modifications and the use of a high temperature PLA, the component cannot withstand the temperature of the steam. The ring will deform due to the heat with each use. We don't think this part is very suitable for 3D printing. The switch seems to be working properly and there are no visible problems. This component is clearly a good example of what can be achieved with 3D printing.
And that's it. Thank you for following the 3D printing for repair process with us. Please consult our 3D printing for repair guide and watch our following videos to obtain more insights and tips on each one of the stages of the process. See you then.